second visit to North America, and the United States Air Force Thunderbirds.
Sean accelerates while climbing almost straight up and reverses direction all within the length of the runway in a maneuver called the Split F. Looking back at the runway, our opposing solo, Captain Todd Canterbury, lifts off, puts wheels in the wells, and executes an immediate roll to the left. Come, ladies and gentlemen, your United States Air Force Air Demonstration Team, the Thunderbirds. From the left, Major Sean Peterson. From the right, Captain Todd Canterbury, inbound for show center at a closing speed of nearly 1,200 miles an hour. Before meeting, they'll bank sharply, avoiding each other with the opposing knife edge pad. And low to the left, the Thunderbirds in trail formation, with each wingman flying directly behind the aircraft in front of him. As they enter a turn, watch as they smoothly transition back into the Thunderbird dynamo. From your left, Captain Canterbury, your opposing solo, Thunderbird 6, upside down in a high-speed inverted path. From the right, Major Sean Peterson in Thunderbird 5. Watch as Sean rolls 360 degrees right at show center. Now, ladies and gentlemen, have your cameras ready for a picture of formation flying at its finest. From behind and to the right, your 2002 Thunderbird Diamond pass in review. And another picture for your scrapbook, this one of the Thunderbird symbol painted on the other side of the aircraft. From the left, Captain Canterbury with the knife edge pass. Now, from your right, watch as Major Peterson uses very precise control inputs to perform the challenging slow roll. To your left once again, this time for the diamond formation and the graceful diamond roll. Inbound from the left, Major Peterson will perform four max performance aileron rolls. Check your watch as Sean rolls four times in just 6 seconds. Now, from the right, it's the arrowhead formation with our two wingmen dropping back to fly off Thunderbird 4 and the arrowhead loop. Again, from the right are our two solo pilots, Sean and Todd, teamed up for their trademark Calypso pass. Watch for the mirror image as Thunderbird 5 rolls inverted and flies canopy to canopy with Thunderbird 6. Cajun French, it's bon ton roulet. In English, let the good times roll. The diamond is now approaching from the left. Watch as all four pilots perform simultaneous aileron rolls right at show center. And now let's listen in as Lieutenant Colonel McSpadden calls the roll.
One. Ready now. It rolls.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, hold on to your hats. Coming from directly behind you, our two solo pilots will pass overhead and execute the breathtaking crossover break. Your Thunderbirds are now in trail formation. As they pull up into the vertical for the clover loop, you'll see them smoothly transition back into the Thunderbird Diamond. Thunderbirds 5 and 6, our solo pilots. Let's watch as each pilot performs an opposing four-point roll, crossing exactly at show center. Looking to your left, you'll see the Thunderbirds again in trail formation, this time for the Trail to Diamond Roll. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a classic example of tactical surprise. Using speed and agility to reach a target undetected, to hit it hard, and return to fight another day. The F-16 is always a superb performer. Look low and to your right as Major Peterson shows you the excellent low-speed handling characteristics of the F-16 with the wing walk. Inbound from your right, the Thunderbird Diamond, gear down, flaps down. High and above, in hot pursuit, look for smoke. It's Thunderbird 6, closing on the Diamond at more than 500 miles per hour. His job is to overtake the formation right in front of you. Timing here is critical, so keep an eye on Captain Canterbury in Thunderbird 6, and let's see if he can do it. Captain Canterbury has pulled into the vertical and executes a half Cuban 8 to reverse direction. At the bottom, he'll climb to his left and work some tough speed and angle problems as he joins up on the Diamond at more than 450 miles per hour. The maneuvers you're watching today require the very same formation flying skills that every young Air Force fighter pilot must learn to master, both in initial training and in developing their advanced air combat skills. The only difference today, our Thunderbirds fly them at lower altitude and in tighter formation. Here's a great example. From the right, look for the Thunderbird 5-card formation and the 5-card loop. Stacked in the center of the 5-card is our slot pilot, Major Rick Boutwell. This is precision flying at its finest, requiring intense concentration and skill. There's no room for error here when you're surrounded by four F-16s. F-16 power. From your left, Major Peterson will climb nearly 3 miles straight up while performing aileron rolls and use just 60% of his engine thrust to do it. As the Thunderbirds form up for the line break loop. As Thunderbird 6 pulls away into his own loop, the remaining pilots will form the Diamond, Then meet Captain Canterbury at show center as they cross in a head-on pass. From the left, Major Peterson will perform a full burner, high G, high performance turn, 360 degrees, 1400 foot radius. He'll follow it with a half Cuban 8 in less than 3500 feet of altitude. High G performance, this time in diamond formation. Look out front for the Diamond 360. Two solo pilots join the Diamond to form the famous Thunderbird six-ship Delta formation and set up for the Delta pass in review. This formation and the series of Delta maneuvers that follow have special meaning for the Thunderbirds, for all Thunderbirds, past and present, for those who fly and those who keep them flying. They represent that special pride in performance and a commitment to excellence that characterize the members of the United States Air Force. And now, ladies and gentlemen, dedicated to our friends here in Abbotsford, your 2002 Thunderbird Delta pass in review. The Delta formation has pulled into the vertical to reposition for the Delta roll. Lieutenant Colonel McSpadden rolls 360 degrees, watches all five wingmen maintain their precise formation positions. We'll be right back. Lieutenant Colonel McSpadden has once again repositioned the Delta. Watch as they enter from the right and perform the six-ship Delta loop. Ladies and gentlemen, perhaps no single maneuver is more closely identified with the Thunderbirds than the one you are about to see. Look low and to your left as the team approaches for the High Bombers. The Bombers' crossover point is located 3,000 feet to the right of show center. Now watch as each aircraft reverses direction in a high-speed dive and races to where the bomb burst began. With closure rates approaching 1,200 miles an hour, the challenge now is for each Thunderbird to get to that bomb burst crossover point at exactly the same time. Now let's go back inside the cockpits of the Thunderbird Diamond as they prepare to make the cross. The next challenge is to reform in diamond formation. Again, speed and timing make the difference. Watch their smoke and let's see how quickly the